I like that it's only 6 minutes. and because I write for a lot of young people, I think this format, I don't know if they thought of this, but it's just amazing that this, in 6 minutes you can tell a good story, and it's something you can watch on your mobile phone, it's on YouTube, I think it's got some 9 million views already and everything, but we're very fortunate to have it here. But I'm going to make sure it's an interesting, fun evening for you, because we have two people who are the wager types. You know, I've met a lot of people in my life, and some people are the wager types, and some people are what they call the settled types. You know, in India there is a word, well settled. Everybody wants a well settled boy. These are not well settled boys, by the way. They take wagers, they take risks, because being well settled means taking no risks. So I'm going to start with Mr. Kapoor here. Sir, you're kicking ass right now. You're just killing it with all your roles, you're peaking. You just told me, we were having a long discussion, and you told me you're peaking and you're probably having more fun than anybody else. Can you tell us a situation like this, when you really wanted something, and that's not something you could buy with money, and then you had to do a wager, you had to do something which was not about money to get it?
I think my entire life has been a wager. You know, it might be personally, it might be professionally. And even physically, in a way. because, you know, from the time I, when I was a kid and I was in school, and but there's no actor in my family, so I just, in school, I came to know there's a film which is, you know, someone's making, and they needed a young kid who would play a young Shashi Kapoor. So I just didn't ask my parents, and I didn't tell anybody, and I just went and auditioned for the film, and I took a chance, and I, you know, got the film. And after I shot for the film, I spoke to my, you know, parents about it so that they couldn't throw me out of the film. So it was... After I shot for the film. And so that's the way I started my career. And it was like a, you know, why I say a wager, because it was not about money. It was not about fame. I just wanted to do it. You know, I just felt that I should do it. It was like a, a risk also at that time. And then, well, life went on, and then I'm from a film production family, and everybody would feel that I would be in production. And then I decided to become an actor. And then obviously everybody had a Kapoor surname.
Yeah.
So Kapoors are supposed to be, you know, glamorous and singing songs and, you know, doing all kind of mainstream commercial films. But I decided to do a film with one of the most artistic directors, and who had made one of the most one of my most favorite films, an artist film, the film which I still admire, one of the best films made in this country, Garam Hawa. And my first film was with M.S. Satyu, Satyu's film. And again, it was not about the contract, or it was not about the money, it was not about the career, or this film will make me into a big star, or I just felt instinctively that I should work and I should do this film. So on and so forth, all my decisions in my career have been more about handshakes, more about instinct, more about, what you saw. It's about how you instinctively about life. Hello.
Just note this one and reduce this.
Yeah. So that's coming to, and of course there are rest of the films which I'm sure I don't have to repeat again and again, the kind of film done and the kind of work I've done. But it's always been about what you're mentioning about Wagga, you know, and
And even personally, well, it's not, you know, like the decisions I've taken in life have been when I, you know, my career took off as an actor, and at that time it was said that, you know, you should be a bachelor, you should not get married, you know, and because you know, you'll have a great fanfaring, and you know, the girls will be crazy about you, and you know, if you get married, your career is going to be over. You know, that's the end of the career. It's not the way it is. People are not as aware, and you know, and you know, there was no social media at that time, and it was not about marketing and all. It was all about the image, and those days that was the done thing. But for me, it was instinct. I said, I didn't care. It's not about the career. I said, for me, it's my word given to my friend who became my girlfriend and now is my wife. So we are together since 42 years now.
Wow. I think that itself is the biggest, you know, achievement these days.
Yeah. So my life, all my decisions have been, I'm sure, you know, Irfan sitting in front of us the film which we did, Slumdog Millionaire, you know, of course, it's, I don't think so we both did the film for money. I don't think so there were any contracts as such.
There was no money, actually.
There was no money, yeah. So it's, you know, it's there are certain, you know, things you do with, it's all about attitude, it's all about swagger, it's about, you know, just a bold thing. I think sabse zabardast ye jo karte hain, mere khayal se sabse shuruaat jo hui Pathano mein hui. They were, they are the, you know, people who really, I feel, for them everything is about, you know, zaban, zaban ki baat hai. It's about story, it's about attitude, it's about class, it's about, you know, panache, it's about, you know, everything which is not calculated.
Sir, agar ispe bahut zyada emphasize karenge to waise hi paisa dete hain ye log. और भी देना बंद कर दे
मुझे तो आदत हो गई बिना पैसे के काम करने की.
So actually it's interesting, it just occurred to me that love is the biggest wager, because when you fall in love, you, there is no contract, there is no money, you just trust that I'm giving you my emotions and you give me your emotions, but I want to come to you, and I haven't I've known you, your work, but I've not known you. But here's what I think: you are Pan Singh Tomar, you're an amazing Spider-Man, you're in Namesake. I think you're having a blast, even though the typical Bollywood path is different. I think you're just having so much fun, and there is obviously a method to this madness that you are in Life of Pi and you're in Pan Singh Tomar, and you're all kind of, and I've seen you in movies like Hustle also, I think, in which you played this UP. I mean, it was just, I know it's a very underrated movie, but it's one of my favorites, including Life of Pi, all this. How, what is the method to this madness, and are you a wager guy? Do you just do it from here, or do you do it from here, contracts?
Actually, I remember one incident. I was reading a book on a set of the film I did with Akshay Kumar, and he saw that book and he said, "Abhi ye kya kar raha hai? Ban kar isko, ban kar, ban kar." मेरा क्या हुआ? बोल, ये घबराहट हो जाती है, बंद कर, मुझे तू कॉन्ट्रैक्ट पढ़वा, कॉन्ट्रैक्ट दे मुझे, मैं कॉन्ट्रैक्ट पढ़ने में मुझे बड़ा मजा आता है. तो सो आई जस्ट रिमेंबर दैट. बट माय थिंग इज, यू नो, वंस समबडी आस्क्ड मी अ क्वेश्चन, आई थिंक इट वाज इन मकबूल्स प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस, एंड आई डोंट नो व्हाई आई सेड दैट, बट आई सेड दैट, यू नो, आई एम ट्राइंग टू मेक माय लाइफ more easy and fun through my acting, and I think that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to have fun and trying to find more than just fame and money and survival, you know, some other, you know, other things through acting, which could put me into a kind of path which could give me something else rather than, you know, just recognition or
And you know, funnily enough, I meet a lot of people, and some of my batchmates who've done very well, there are batchmates of mine who opened big corporations and things like that, and once they have that much money, they start talking the same way. They start talking the same way as the film. They start talking like you guys. It doesn't become about the money anymore. They just want to feel that meaning. They want to feel it, right? They want to feel something. But, you know,
Recognition and money, after a point, you know, if it doesn't give you more than that, that becomes very, it's not satisfying, you know. It leaves you empty. You know, it leaves your batteries like, you know, somebody has drained your batteries out and nothing is coming back in.
But, you know, that's something which a lot of people face. Like, I know, like, a lot of professionals, they say, how do you contend with the fact that somebody else who's gone for money will live in a big house or in a posher neighborhood or will have a better car? How do you deal with that?
I think I had to do a lot of thinking, and I wanted big house, I wanted big cars, and my work and my, you know, things, the way things happened to me, they actually guided me and they gave me kind of clues, signals, and I really caught on to it. Like, I'll give you an example. I was in 2000, I was doing this film called Warrior, and at the same time I was also producing a series for Star Plus, because I got bored of acting in television. So I was trying to produce or direct, you know. At that time, this film came. And I, for the first time, I went, like, I did a shooting which was in one chunk. So this was the first time I experienced how the story, how the character grows on you in those days, if you are doing it continuously, or if you have that kind of atmosphere. And towards the end of the shoot, my wife came to meet me, and she was worried that, you know, we have invested so much of money on the series, what's going to happen? And suddenly something told me from inside that, you know, don't go that way. You are not enjoying that. You know, producing series is not your cup of tea. You are not enjoying that experience. And I left that. I never, you know, turned back and looked at it. I said, no, I'm not going that way. I have to go this way. I don't know what will happen, but I'll go this way.
I want to ask you two things. One thing is how you got 24 to India. And, you know, you may not have realized this, but I found what is amazing about the story is you told me how you asked them for it and they said, wait for it, we'll let you know. And you were behaving like a newcomer there again, whereas you've had 3 decades of superstardom here, 100 movies. And tell us that 24 story. I love that. Like, tell us in brief about how you got 24 to India, because it wasn't that simple, and it's not a question of how much does it cost and I want to bring to India. You had to put a wager on that one.
Yeah, you know,
exactly, because you see, 24, what I did in America, the American show which I did, that was all about contract, and it was a very professional decision. And getting 24 to India was exactly what this film is all about. That the first day of my shoot, and I read the script, the first episode, and I said, I have to take this to India. And Howard Gordon, one of the most respected, and he's the showrunner of Homeland as well as 24, and written a lot of books also. So I met him, and I said, I want to take 24 to India. So he just looked at me. I said, as he wants to take 24 to India, you know who he's talking to, and who are the stakeholders of 24 internationally. They're all billionaires, and you can't offer me anything. So he just looked at me. I said, you finish this 24 and then we'll talk about this. So obviously I was there for 6 months, and I completely, you know, not that I was working, and what I was doing was exactly thinking that I have to take, you know, to India, but obviously back of the mind it was there, but that was not the main motivation. But somewhere the professionalism and the work ethics and the way I am, and I think somewhere the way I worked over there, as you said, that I was like a newcomer over there, and I was like a newcomer, and they felt that I'm a like-minded person, and it's not about money and it's not about contract. He wants to take, they must have realized it, that it's all about the kind of person I am and what I want to do with the show. And the last day of the shoot of 24 America,
we had a big celebration. They had a big celebration for me. And I said, and then I said, let me go and say bye to him. So I went up to the office, and then I said, you remember you told me about you want to take 24 to India. And yes, sir. I said, of course I have. I said, you know, I want
to. Did you say sir? Did you actually say sir to them?
Yeah, yeah. I said sir to you and to Irwan sir also. Yeah. Basically, I respect all youngsters.
Thank you.
Yeah. He's younger to me, Howard Gordon. Yeah. And and he picked up the phone and made all his calls to all the stakeholders. He called up 20th Century Fox, and today 24 India is kind of a big game changer in, you know, on Indian television. Every channel I hear, every actor, every production house wants to do something like 24. I said, 24 jaisa kuch karte hain, 24 jaisa kuch karte hain. Agar 24 jaisa kahani hai, 24 jaisa paisa mile ek show ke liye, you know, it's all about that. So, you know, in a way, if I had, you know, it was not about how much money I'm going to make, because I was risking my career, you know, doing television, and that also coming to India and doing fiction, because all the big stars and major stars have done reality shows.
Yeah.
And even I was offered all the reality shows, quite a few of them. But I just didn't feel instinctively, I said, it was for me, it was not the money. I just didn't feel that I would enjoy being a judge or being a host. And I feel that's not me. For me, I would enjoy acting. I would enjoy something which is a great role, great storytelling. And 24 is all about storytelling. It's about great writing. And, you know, I did it in India and it just paid off. So it was a
But he just says, I just did it and it paid off. I just asked him, when is the next season? He said, it's happening soon. I said, how long will it take? He said, 200 days non-stop shooting. It's not like I just did it. You
yeah,
did
matter
it
of fact,
for 200
I,
days non-stop.
Honestly, to be honest, I can make much more money doing feature films.
Yeah.
And, you know, and doing
because 24
things.
Is 24 hours.
Yeah,
right?
It's about,
it's a real-time show.
It's almost like making 12 films. And now I'm starting my second season very soon. And of course, when I started the first season, I had a commitment to the second season also, and they all are very happy with it. The channels are happy. The channel is happy. The board is happy. So, and I'm looking forward to the second season.
I am too, and I'm going to ask a question to both of you. Although Irfan will have a very short answer to that, I know why. When you do wagers, when you do these crazy things in life, and it applies to everybody, there's a lot of criticism. Why Irfan will have a short answer is, I've never seen you being criticized. Critics love you.
No,
I think
no,
they,
no, no.
They love you.
I'll give you examples.
Just, okay, give me example. Maybe you can give an example. And for you, you have taken so many what we call in India pangas or so many wagers or so many of these things that I'm sure people have criticized and made you doubt yourself and like, what the hell am I doing? Why do I have to do this? Even my daughter is acting now. I can just sit back and chill. What is that thought process? Because I think it's very helpful for people here. But let's quickly, darling of the critics, Irfan, answer it. Like, what criticism me?
Actually, for me, I am so critical of myself that I don't need any other critics, you know. It's from my childhood. It's like given by God that I have to criticize myself. Because the first sentence I learned about to speak was a criticism about myself, you know. So it's and I'm very comfortable with it now. Earlier I was, I suffered from this tendency. And when I thought of becoming an actor, it was like, you know, impossible, because I was so thin, dark, odd looking guy. I'm still odd looking, but you know, I was so shy that nobody could have imagined that I could become an actor. I couldn't even tell to my friends that I could become an actor. If I would have told them, they would have made fun of me, you know. So I just kept this desire in me and I...
So you may be your only critic, but let me tell you one thing I've learned. Don't listen to the critics. So, and how about you? You've done things which are... I'm sure you've had a lot of...
Well, you know, he didn't tell anybody, his friends, that he wanted to be an actor, but I did tell my friends that I wanted to be an actor, and I was criticized and made fun of. But I used it as whenever anybody makes fun of me, makes me work harder. So I wait sometimes for people to make fun of me. and or criticize me, so because they don't know what they're in for, you know. So it just makes me work doubly harder.
Okay, so if bricks are thrown at you, you are going to make a house.
Well, I think palace.
Palace. Yeah. Okay, that's a good answer. Really good answer. I'm going to end this evening with one last question, which I actually, because the event was taking its time to start, I asked him a question, which I didn't think I'll ask here, but I really liked his answer. And I'm going to ask Anil the last question, which is, what made you do this? Why are you doing a Johnny Walker Blue Label event? I know you don't do endorsements that much. You've done this. There has to be a bigger reason, because I know you are not the brand endorsement kind of person, or you don't work with brands so much. You've done this event. Why?
Well, I think all of you all will be surprised, but it's a very emotional moment for me. It's a very emotional decision. You know, it might sound with a Black Label bottle over here, and all of us, Blue Label, sorry. Blue, Black, Yeki, it's the same family, yeah. But it's Blue Label, yeah. It's rare. It's classy. It's fantastic. And well, of course, I've had Blue Label, and I love it. And the reason is, my father was completely obsessed and passionate about Johnny Walker. For him, his life, not only my father, I think, you know, the great Raj Kapoor also. So when they came to me and they spoke about Blue Label and Johnny Walker Blue Label, I said, I have to be part of this event. So obviously, you know, like, people would react. I said, it's an alcohol, you know, and that, you know, of course, you know, alcohol, as you say, is legal, you know, it's fine. There's nothing, I can't be a hypocrite, because I also drink sometimes, and I love a peg of Blue Label, or a Black Label, or whatever. So I said, I must go there, and I think I would, and I started remembering my father, and how he would love his Johnny Walker. Obviously, Blue Label was unaffordable, and I could not really, my father could not really afford to buy a bottle of Blue Label, because so it was either the Red Label or the Black Label. And then when I would travel for shootings and, you know, go abroad, and all my friends would go, and then I would get this bottle of Blue Label for my father. He wouldn't want anything. He just didn't want anything. No shirt, no suit, no shoes. Nothing, no electronics. Was a bottle Johnny Walker ki liana putar. So that was his, you know, that was his obsession. So I said, so today I, you know, in a way, I remember my father and I dedicate this evening.
And tell us about, you told me this, you've still kept the half-finished bottles.
Yes. You know, there are some bottles which are still there. And there are about 3 Blue Label bottles, you know, in my house, which I preserve and keep it. And I don't open it because, you know, I feel somewhere, I think when I go up there, I'm going to, you know, try to take them along. And give it to my dad.
not empty bottles.
You can't top that for a last answer. And I think you guys inspire me for sure. I have a long way to go to think like you guys, and I think it's you've inspired the audience, and your just honesty tonight, and it just shows that this pays off in life sometimes. Sometimes wagers pay off, and we gotta do them, because our dreams are worth it. Your dreams are, you can't price them, you know. You can't say that I will sell my dreams for this price. Your dreams are yours. You have one life, one set of dreams, and you gotta live them. And thanks once again for coming to this event, and I think we really enjoyed ourselves. I hope you did too. And there is obviously Johnny Walker Blue Label, so how bad can it be anyway? Thank you so much. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you very much. You've been very insightful, and it's been an absolute pleasure having you all here. And now, moving along, I'd like to invite on stage Mr. Bhavesh Somaya, Director Marketing and Innovations, Diageo India.
On honestly, guys, please have a seat. I think it was an amazing discussion, and thank you so much for being with us and bringing this whole film and campaign and what it stands for to life. I think honestly, I was truly inspired by the stories that you've shared of your own journeys, and I think the three of you truly embody the rare and the pioneering spirit of Johnnie Walker Blue Label and all that the brand stands for.
Solely towards the event today and the film that we just screened. Anyone? Hi. Questions?
Anil Ji, namaskar.
Mike.
Irfan Ji, namaskar.
Hi,
sir. My question is from you both. इस फिल्म आप दोनों ने स्लम डॉग में काम किया, ये 6 मिनट की फिल्म देखते हो, कहीं आपके जन में यह था कि काश हम दोनों ने इसमें भी काम किया होता?
So I'm going to just translate it for some people who may not. He said, did you see the 6 minute film and felt, hey, it would have been fun to be a part of this film too?
Yeah, I think मिलता तो we would have done a great job, no?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. इच्छा आई नहीं, लेकिन आप बोल रहे हैं तो अभी अब लग रहा है कि हाँ करना चाहिए था।
But who would have danced and who would have not danced?
I think I should have danced.
So Arjun gets the Jude Law role?
Yeah, of course. Irfan would do the Jude Law role.
उस बोट के लिए नाचा जा सकता है।
Interesting, good question. Next. Now when I'm writing and it's working out, but I actually used to work in investment bank, right? I used to work in Goldman Sachs, Deutsche Bank, and I was making a lot of money there. And when I left, I had an income drop of 95%. Basically, I had almost nothing. I still left with the assumption that this is never going to go up again, ever in life. It's not happened. It came back. The money came back and everything. Yes, you are right that you need a certain level. And I think what you're trying to imply is, are these higher order needs? But I think it's something to do with the kind of person you are and what choices you make very early in life. I don't think Irfan was that rich when he made some of the choices he made. I don't think he could have become in the production side, right? He had a steady career from his family, that was a steady career. He could have gone, sat in the dukan, and that's his thing. But he chose to do something different. And at that time, he didn't think, I'm doing this because I'll make a lot of money doing this. So I think, yes, you are right that you need a certain level to do this, but it also, it's not as much that you only do this when you have a lot of money. I think we've all done crazy things when we didn't have money also. Like him getting married. I mean, it sounds easy now, but 42 years back, I can imagine, like the magazines.
No, I didn't get married 42 years back. As a lawyer, 70 years ago.
Sorry, yeah, that's true. How can you get married? But you said you're together for 42 years.
30 years, yeah.
So you knew her from school?
Yes.
That's even cuter.
Yeah, from school, yeah.
Your wife is from your school.
Yeah,
it is
yeah.
As cool as it gets.
Yeah.
But I'm just saying, to get married at that time, those were real risks. You know, those are not, that's not something you do. But,
to be honest with you, I feel, you should never chase commerce. I think commerce, automatically, if you do something from your heart, from your instinct, and what you passionately enjoy, I think commerce will chase you. You know, I feel that's what I believe. That's been my philosophy. That whatever I've done, aisa bhi hua hai ki ek do baar, teen baar maine paise ke liye kuch cheezein ki and I've fallen flat on my face. But whenever I've done something, earlier in my stage of my career, when I started in 1978, and now it is 2014, but whenever I've done things, not keeping money in mind, it's given me tenfolds.
Irfan, now that you're rolling in money, maybe you want to answer.
I wish. One day, I will. I think there are two situations. One is that you are earning loads of money and you don't have any interest in that job. So that's a pathetic way to earn money. And the other is that you are passionate about job and you are still getting money. I think that's a very fortunate.
That's a key difference.
That's a fortunate situation. That's again a fortunate situation. You can sustain your passion, That's
will these
great.
Guys be acting if their income dropped 90%? The answer is yes. If will I be still writing if my income dropped 90%? The answer is yes. So I think that's the kind of thing that we love doing what we do. So I think that's it.
गुड इवनिंग इरफान जी, आप दोनों से सवाल है. जब पहली बार आप ऑडिशन दे रहे थे उस वक्त क्या फीलिंग
थी? कहां
है आप? मे आई जस्ट रिक्वेस्ट, आई डोंट मीन टू बी लाइक, आई मीन बिकॉज़ वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ फॉरेन गेस्ट्स हियर, इफ इट्स ओके विद यू, इफ यू कैन जस्ट
यू कैन ट्रांसलेट दैट प्लीज, बिकॉज़ आई बिलोंग टू हिंदी चैनल.
ओह या, इट्स फाइन फाइन.
आप दोनों से सवाल ये है कि जब आप पहला ऑडिशन दे रहे थे, क्या आपको याद है? और ऑडिशन देते वक्त आप दोनों के दिमाग में क्या चल रहा था?
What was the first audition like and what was going on in your mind?
So actually, I have a very strange relationship with auditions. I have never got any part through audition. Whenever I give audition, I fail. So I'm not a person, you know, who's very competitive, who thrives in competition. So I bypass whenever a role comes and it demands audition. I say bye-bye because it doesn't happen with me. I feel very odd when I'm doing an audition and I know that people are testing you or, you know, trying to judge you. That, I know, I don't enjoy that situation.
Well, my first audition, though, as I said, was when I was in 7th standard, when I was a kid. And of course, I got the film. Uske baad jitne bhi audition kiye, fail ho gaya main. As Irfan said, you see, it's not in our... To be honest with you, it's now becoming more and more in our culture and in the work ethics of audition. But somewhere I think we've not been brought up or educated. And internationally, I think every actor is to a certain extent groomed and educated to audition. We are not as much.